In the 1920s, airplanes were a novelty, an adventure, and they first landed in Charlotte on a polo field near the corner of Selwyn Avenue and Queens Road. With those airplanes, Charlotte saw its future in flight. From those first breathtaking moments, Charlotteans were hooked.
Going back to Johnny Crowell Sr., when I first came to Charlotte, he was among those early aviators that flew and was involved in aviation and developing aviation. And he was, back in those days, it was air shows and called barnstorming, and he would fly on those and do his aerobatics in a biplane. And he would actually fly with his hands tied to the top wing where the hand holds up there. They'd tie his hands, and he would start the plane, take off and land, and take off, maneuver, and do several maneuvers with his hands still tied, and come in and land with his hands tied up and cut the engine off. And he would never tell anybody how he did this.
By 1926, Charlotte had an airport on 220 acres of land off Tuckasegee Road. The crowds still came for the barnstorming shows, but when that first airmail delivery landed on the gravel runway on April 2, 1930, it was clear to everyone that aviation meant business in Charlotte. Airlines were starting up all over the place in the 1930s. One airline in particular, Eastern, started a New York-Atlanta-Miami run, and Charlotte wasn't ready to let the opportunity pass it by. Enter Mayor Ben Douglas, an enthusiastic Chamber of Commerce, a visionary city council, and some help from the federal WPA, the Works Progress Administration. Mary Louise Douglas recalls her husband, former Mayor Ben Douglas.
Eddie Rickenbacker, and he were friends, and he knew that Ben was interested in starting an airport in Charlotte, and he said that he would bring his airline there, and that was the first airline. And as a side effect, Eddie Rickenbacker, in his older years, lived in Paris. The last letter he wrote was to Ben.
Soon, Charlotte had a real airport. When Charlotte Municipal Airport opened on May 17, 1937, off Wilkinson Boulevard, the first four-lane highway in North Carolina. The new airport boasted three runways over a half mile long, a two-story administration building, and a hangar and lighting system.
I remember the original terminal. It sat at the end of Harley Avenue on a little knoll right at the end of the one runway. And it was a two-story building. I don't remember if it was rock or like concrete, but it was a gray-looking like building. And of course, the reason that I remember it, I was a very small child at the time, but my aunt and uncle ran the cafe or the restaurant that was in the building. And it was not fancy, you know, it was just little square tables. And I specifically remember the salt and pepper shakers and the heavy restaurant-type china that they had. And on Saturdays and Sundays, people from the city would come out to look at the airplanes. And it was busy. It was a very festive place at that particular time.
Then came World War II, and Charlotte Mayor Douglas lobbied for one of the Army's planned 18 new airfields. In the spring of 1941, Morris Field was opened and started training thousands of fighter pilots and maintenance crews for service overseas. Life at Morris Field included lots of work and also entertainment, including a visit from comedian Bob Hope. After the war, the city reclaimed its airport from the Army, and air travel became more and more commonplace. And Charlotte was working hard to keep up. Longer runways were constructed, and a new terminal opened in 1954 with U.S. Weather Bureau facilities, an observation deck, a coffee shop, and the Dogwood Room, where many Charlotteans went to dine and even get married.
Everyone would come at the Dogwood Room. They was telling me to have lunch and to see their loved ones off on the plane. And they would go on the balcony of the Dogwood Room, and you were able to see it's a clear view where that you'll see the loved ones walk out and get on the plane. Then when the plane come in, they would walk off the plane and come in, and it was like an upstairs. They come in and they see the Dollar Room, they use the Dollar Room, or either go downstairs to the dive house to eat.
The new airport also got a new name. Charlotte Municipal Airport now became Douglas Municipal Airport, honoring the airport's initial champion. And by now, several of the major airlines of the day were flying into Charlotte. North Carolina's own Piedmont Airlines, Eastern Airlines, and Atlanta-based Delta Airlines. Then in 1962, the first jet airliner landed at Charlotte, and a whole new era of air transportation began. At the start of the 1960s, Charlotte was moving over 363,000 passengers a year through its gates. But by 1970, that number had exploded to 815,000 passengers a year. And despite expansion, Charlotte was now ready for some major changes. During those years, Charlotte was making a name for itself with service, thanks to people like Skycap Sandy Linton, the Candy Man.
Here at the airport, I'm mostly known as the Candy Man because I try to give everybody candy, especially the kids, and they just love the lollipops. And I give out the candy because I started out eating mints, and everybody seemed to want some, and I wanted to share it with them. So I got other kinds of variety.
Thanks to the leadership of the new airport manager at the time, Josh Birmingham, business leader and Mayor John Belk, and with the enthusiastic support of the people of Charlotte, now Douglas Municipal Airport was on its way to becoming Charlotte Douglas International Airport.
This area has always been developed as a distribution center from 200 years ago, probably, when it was first started. And so we needed to get our role back that we had when we had the trucking centers here and this type of thing. And as far as I was concerned, our new mode of transportation was by air. And of course, I'm prejudiced in that area about flying. And so that's where I would just talk to people and they would agree to it, especially. And also to have something we're proud of so that we could connect to major centers around the country and attract businesses here. And because the chamber told me, the first thing they ask about is what's the status of your airport development? How are you going to improve it so that we could have flights here, et cetera? And that's where we got it.
As the airlines were changing and growing, Charlotte's state-of-the-art airport was growing quickly. The new Federal Aviation Administration control tower opened in 1978, followed in 1982 by the impressive Charlotte Douglas International Airport with 25 gates instead of the originally planned 20 on two concourses.